Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I have a IP camera here. It's a Hikvision Prime, and today I'm going to show you on how to set up this one as a standalone. When I said standalone, it will be just by itself. So basically, I'm going to connect this one directly to the network switch. I'm not gonna use any NVR or network video recorder for this one. And also, I will going to show you on how to set up this one and your QNAP NAS to use the QNAP NAS as a network storage or a storage device for this IP camera. So basically, this one will be recording a video to the QNAP NAS. And then you can play back later on. We will also going to configure our mobile phone to view the IP camera from the mobile apps, and also we will going to access the camera as well to our computer through the web interface. I'm just gonna quickly show you the connectors for this IP camera. So basically, it has this network port. This is where you plug in your network cable, and also this one here, it comes with a power port. This is where you plug in your 12 volts power adapter or power supply. And you use this one if you don't have a power over Ethernet network switch or injector or any device that is a power over Ethernet with 802.3af. I don't have a power over Ethernet switch or device at the moment, so I will be using a 12 volts power supply. This is only for a demonstration purposes, so I'm not gonna worry about it. But if you are going to use this for production, if you are using just a single camera, then you can buy a single power injector. Or if you are planning to use multiple camera, maybe around 3 or 4, then I suggest you get a power over Ethernet or PoE 802.3af network switch, so that you don't have to worry or you are not limited for the location of the camera. Because if you are using this one, you are limited. You need to have a power outlet beside your camera. Unlike if you are using a PoE network switch, then you can just run a cable up to 100 meters and everything will work, okay? So let's connect this things up and we'll go to the configuration after. So I have now the camera plugin, and as you can see, that's my QNAP NAS. This one here is now connected to the network and the power, and it's plugged into my network switch. Okay guys, once everything is plugged in, all you need to do is go to your computer and open the SADP tool. If you don't have this tool here, you can download it to the Hikvision website and look for this installer, and it's free. So install it in your computer. Basically, what this tool do is it will scan devices or Hikvision devices or IP camera NVR that are on the same network of your computer. Like this one here, as you can see, I have two devices here that is being detected by this tool, which is this one here is my NVR, but we're not gonna use this one. What we are looking at is this IP camera here, this one here. So why we are opening this one? It's because we want to identify the IP address of that IP camera. Anyway, once you got that IP address, then all you have to do is open Internet Explorer and browse to that IP address. Right, so it's 70. I know there's lots of ways to identify the IP address. You can also check to your modem or router and check your DHCP list and see what IP address of the camera, but you have to find out your MAC address. It's not easy, especially if you have a lot of devices in the network, but using this tool, it's very easy because once you run this application, it will automatically detect whatever Hikvision devices that's in the network, and from there you can see straight away, oh okay, this is the IP address, right? So let's log into that one, and as you can see, I can access that camera in the web interface, and that is standalone, so it is not using NVR at the moment. And if you go to the playback, you cannot see any recording in there because we haven't set up the storage for this one, and that is the one that I'm going to show you. So as you can see here, if you go to the configuration, go to the advanced here, advanced, and go to the storage management. As you can see, there's no hard drive in there at the moment, and to configure it we need to go to the NAS. But before we do that, we need to configure our QNAP device first. We need to set up a shared folder from there. It will be the same configuration as what I did for the NVR storage. It will be exactly the same, but I will just do a quick run for that one for you. Let's do that now. Let's jump into our QNAP NAS. So basically, you need to create a volume first by going to the storage and snapshots, and you go to the storage, and from there you go create. So you can see I have 4 data volumes there. Go create and then new volume, and you just use the tick volume. The one I'm using tick volume for the whole thing, this one here, and the storage full, you need to select which storage full, which I only have 1, and it will calculate an allocated space. I have 1.53 terabyte available space, so I just go next, then it will automatically create a volume alias, and now it's 5 because I already have 4. And then you put in size that you want. Let's say I'm just gonna create 10. The reason for that one is that it will take a while for this to create because it's trying to format and everything like that. Actually, I'm just gonna make it, yeah, 10 should be fine. Go next. Yeah, 10 gig capacity, click finish. And it says now volume data 5 is being created. All right, let's just close this one. See, at the moment it's initializing, and it says 100%. It will format, and now it's still formatting. That's only 10 gig. All right, so the volume is now ready, and you can now start to create a shared folder. So let's close this one, and you go to control panel and go to the shared folders, or you can also go to the file station, but I prefer to go here, it's more easy, and for me it's more quicker. Then you go create shared folder, and you name it, which I'm gonna name it as COM 101. And here it will ask you to select which volume, which is this one. We're gonna select the one that we just created and specify path automatically. That's fine. Go next, and that one we just go next on that one as well. From here we just leave it like that as well. Let's just go finish, leave everything as default, click finish, just click OK on that one, and that will create a shared folder. Okay, so we get the COM 101 created. Once you got that created, you need to change some shared folder permission here. You go in here, edit shared folder permission, and go in here on the top, NFS host access. Make sure the COM 101 is selected, right? And you go access right. Yeah. And from here, you need to click add. And you need to add the IP address of the camera, which is 88.70.192.168.88.70. And from here, says read only, you have to make sure it is read write and click apply, and you have to check IP address and read and write. Yep. And then you can close, and basically that's it for the QNAP configuration. All right, let me go to the camera and let's see if we can add that QNAP NAS drive. Okay, so let's go to storage again and go to the NAS tab and click the NAS and put in the IP address of your NAS, the QNAP NAS IP address, 88.88.33, in the file path. The one that we created is COM 101, so it will be slash COM 101. That will be the file path, forward slash COM 101, and then you go test, check if it will be successful, and which is testing succeed. So it means that we are connected. And now you go click the save button, make sure to save, and you go to storage management, and there you go, you should be able to see this one here. And at the moment you can see it says uninitialize, then you have to format this one, and that's the reason that you need to create a disk, a dedicated disk for this one, because if you were going to use the existing disk that you have already in there, that will format the whole disk. You need to be careful. Click the format, format the HDD. All you have to do is wait. Lucky we only put in 10 gig there, so it will be quick. At the moment it says 52%, 55%, and there you go. Now you can see that the status has changed to normal, which means that you can start recording. So to make sure that it is recording, you need to go to the storage record schedule, and at the moment it's not enabled, so you need to enable this one, enable record schedule, and it is continuously recording according to the color. And you can check that one if you wanna verify. Says all day continuous, Tuesday continuous, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It's up to you if you wanna continuous, or you just want the motion detection, you want just the alarm or all the events. It's up to you. But for this demo, I'm just gonna leave it as continuous. I'm just gonna press OK. and save succeed, and that should be starting to record. I don't have indication in here because unlike the NVR, you can see that it's recording in the monitor. But for us to verify this one is you go to playback. As you can see, we are on the 20th of November. There's no recording at the moment. If there's a recording, there will be a blue line there, color, which is the scheduled. As you can see, command is green, blue is scheduled, pink is alarm, manual is yellow. Nothing at the moment. So we're gonna come back maybe around 5 minutes. Okay, while waiting for the recording, let's open the application in the mobile phone. So I'm gonna go to the IVMS 4500, go to the device, and I'm going to add a device and manual adding. Click the manual adding. I'm just gonna say alias for this one is COM101, and register mode will be IP domain, and the address for that one will be 192.168.88.70, and the port, if you look at the configuration, the port that we use, oh, in the SADP tool, as you can see, the port that's being used is 808. You can change that, you can configure that in the web GUI. In here, as you can see, you have the control for the port. At the moment, it's 8008, so we'll put 8008 for that, and the username admin and the password, and save and start live view. And there you go, should be able to see that. As you can see, we can see the camera in our mobile apps now. So that's it for the mobile app. Now let's go back to the playback. Let's have a look if we have a recording. And as you can see, I get a blue line here. It means that I have a recording already. So at the moment, you can see my time is 1:11. I'm just gonna play back that one. That's 1:05. So 5 minutes ago or 6 minutes ago, I got a recording. So that's it, guys. That's how you configure your IP camera as a standalone, and also maximizing your QNAP NAS as a storage. In this case, you don't need NVR. I hope you learned something for this video tutorial, guys, and please don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you on my next video.